Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today I'm going to walk you through the procedure to remove the lower unit on our Mercury Tracker 40 horsepower, the two-stroke version of it. It's not that tough to do. Let me go grab a couple of basic hand tools and we'll get it removed and put in our stand. All right, guys, we're going to start off by just trimming this up to make it easier to work on. And then we're going to disconnect the shift shaft. Now, this one's a little bit different. On most of the Mercury models, you do the disconnection up top behind the cowling. This one is at the midway point, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. We just need to get a couple of jam nuts removed, and then we'll actually split the shift shaft at the halfway point. So let's get this thing trimmed up, and then I'll show you how to do it. Here's what we're talking about. We want to break this loose and then bring it up, or we can separate the shift shaft right there. What you will need to do this are a couple of 10 millimeter wrenches. There we go. Disconnect it like that. Next, we have 5 bolts to deal with. You've got the 4 up here, and then remember, you've got 1 hidden up in here. And in this case, the anode was actually eaten away, but you would typically need to remove that one first, and then there's another one hidden up behind it. Now, the bolt for the anode is the 13, which, like I said, of course, most of mine is missing. Hopefully, yours is not in the same condition. And the one that's hidden up inside is a 15 millimeter. There you are. Don't lose your washer. Now, the other 4 are 16 millimeters. We're going to go ahead and remove these other 3 and then do this one last. That way I can get a good grip on it, because when I release this last one, it's going to be free. I wouldn't want to drop it on the floor. Here's when you need to go ahead and have a hand down below it. It's not going to jump off, but just in case. All right, see, she's ready to come loose. Now, what you're feeling there is just a couple of dowels that you have to work past, as well as the water connections. They usually have a rubber transition piece, and when she's ready to go, it goes. There's that transition piece I'm talking about. Now we'll just bring her all the way out, take it over to the stand. Well, all right, guys, that's going to wrap up this video, but there are several other procedures we're going to do to this particular unit. We've already done the prop shaft seals. We're going to dive into the water pump and then the input shaft seals. And if you need help doing that, why don't you go ahead and reference the playlist for this particular unit? That way I can walk you through it. Well, listen, if you have any questions or comments thus far, why don't you go ahead and leave them in the section below, and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, you like what you see? Why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you'll be notified of whatever I'm working on next. Listen, we just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.